Hi, this video is an in-depth comparison of the 2018 Acer Predator Helios 300 and the new generation from 2019. Both laptops are well known for the best price-to-performance ratio out there, but buying which one actually pays off better? In this video we will find the answer, so before you buy, take few minutes to watch this comparison to the end and make a wise choice. As always, in the video description I left Amazon links for USA and this time also for other countries to check the current prices. To skip to any part of this video, you can use the timestamps down below. I'm Chris from techfindsreview.com and now let's jump into the comparison. If it comes to design, the 2018 model is black with red accents. The lid is made of metal, it has brushed aluminum texture, two red lines, the Predator logo in the middle and a nice looking strip on the top. The deck is metal with brushed aluminum texture as well, and around the edges of the laptop you can find silver trim. The bottom is made of plastic that feels very solid. On the back you can find one massive red exhaust, but actually only one side is functional. The new generation keeps the same theme and build quality with few minor changes. You have metal lid, this time with matte texture. The lines on the lid are blue and the logo in the middle has blue stroke which is backlit. The deck is metal with matte texture and you can find the same silver trim as in old model, but only on the front of the laptop. The bottom is made of plastic that feels solid but not as much as in old model. The back in new Predator looks awesome. I love the triangular exhaust with blue heatsinks inside. The interior of 2018 model has thicker screen bezels with the 720p webcam on the top. There are a few red accents on WSAD keys, around the touchpad and on the sticker from Acer. The 2019 model has thin bezel display but the 720p webcam is still located properly on the top. It has transparent blue strokes on WSAD keys, arrow keys and the Predator button. The touchpad and sticker have blue accenting as well. If it comes to dimensions, the new model is noticeably smaller thanks to thin bezel display. It's also a little bit lighter and it has much smaller power brick, so if the portability is important to you, this is the way to go. The keyboard in new Predator has been improved. It has 1.7mm key travel, good spacing and comfortably big arrow keys. You have also one dedicated key to open the Control Center app and one turbo button which improves the performance and sets the fans to max, more on that later. The keys with white sides are eye-catching and the lighting is more visible now. You have 4 zones of lighting and few simple effects so you can customize the keyboard a bit. But please note that the most popular $1200 model with 1660 Ti comes with only blue keyboard lighting in the USA. The models with higher specs and some of 1660 Ti models come with RGB, so make sure that you buy the right one. The keyboard in the old model has a bit shallow 1.2mm key travel but good spacing. It was good enough and I had no complaints when using it, but since this is a comparison I have to point out that it lacks features compared to the keyboard in new Predator. It has only red backlight which is not as good quality as in 2019 model and it has no even additional key for Control Center app or boosting the fans. The touchpads in both laptops seem to be exactly the same. Both use Windows Precision drivers so you can take advantage of the gesture controls and the tracking is good. They are the same size, the surface is the same smooth and they both have the same clicking mechanism under the touchpad. If it comes to port selection, the 2019 model has newer and faster USB ports and mini display port, but it lacks SD card slot compared to the older model. For those who ask, no Thunderbolt 3 support in both laptops. The display in 2018 Predator is 1080p, 144Hz IPS panel with 7ms response time. The G-Sync is not available here, but the display is fairly smooth and fast enough for gaming nowadays. The 2019 model has also 1080p, 144Hz IPS panel, but with 3ms response time. Despite it doesn't support G-Sync, I find it one of the smoothest and fastest 144Hz panels that I've seen so far. It's better than older Predator's display with no doubt, but it's actually competitive to the display of $600 more expensive Asus SCAR 3. The color accuracy is almost the same for both laptops. However, the older model has warmer tones and it's slightly dimmer, while the new model looks like it's calibrated perfectly since the colors are more real. It can reproduce 97% of sRGB color gamut, 75% of Adobe RGB, and the brightness is 315 nits. For 2018 model, the sRGB color coverage is 98%, 76% of Adobe RGB, and the brightness is 300 nits. These are the photos of the displays in dark room to reveal the backlit bleeding. It's hard to say which one is worse basing on them, but since this vary between laptops, you can be sure that your unit will have different amount or will have no backlight bleeding at all. In my case, it was only slightly visible in the 2019 model when the content on the screen was black. The camera was able to capture much more than human's eye can see. If it comes to sound, the new model is the winner. It has noticeably more bass than 2018 model and many other gaming laptops. I was surprised how clear was the sound. On stock settings it has a lot of detail and depth, but if you want you can equalize it in Waves Max Studio software. The older Predator on stock settings sounds more flat compared to the new generation, but you can use the Dolby Audio software to equalize it a bit. Okay, let's quickly mention other configurations and prices of both laptops. There is not much of it for the 2018 model. You can get it with GTX 1050 Ti, GTX 1060 and various storage and RAM options. I've got the configuration with GTX 1060 which costs $999 and from time to time it goes on sale for $899, so I think that it's a good option if you're tight on the budget. However, I highly recommend saving up few bucks more to buy the new generation. You can choose between the GTX 1660 Ti, RTX 2060 or RTX 2070 Max-Q. It's also available with different storage and RAM options. The most popular $1200 model is what I've got here, and as we know from the previous generations, Acer likes to put the laptops on sale. The GTX 1660 Ti model was actually for $999 on Amazon for a limited time, and it most likely will be on sale again in Black Friday, so stay tuned. You can check the current prices in the description below. Alright, let's talk about the performance, where the things get interesting. It is certain that the new model will perform better, since it comes with more powerful CPU and GPU, but the results of my test clearly show that it has no limitations while the older model cannot use its full potential due to performance loss caused by thermal throttling. The 2019 Predator is insanely fast right out of the box thanks to efficient cooling system which allows to maintain the maximum 4 GHz multi-core clock speeds for i7-9750H and 1.94 GHz for GTX 1660 Ti while gaming. The 2018 model ran at 3.6 to 3.7 GHz on the i7-8750H and 1.85 on GTX 1060. Here is a quick preview of how it translates into the game performance, but if you want more details, you can check out my gaming benchmark videos for both laptops where I tested 20 games on each of them. If you're curious how the configuration with RTX 2060 performs in games, I will also leave the link for gaming benchmark video made by Matthias Tech and his comparison between GTX 1660 Ti and RTX 2060 models of 2019 Helios 300. Above the keyboard in 2019 Predator you have the turbo button which instantly rises up the fan speeds to maximum and overclocks the GPU core and memory. It also increases the CPU power limit from 45 to 56 watts. You definitely wanna use turbo mode for gaming, but keep in mind that in order to maintain highest possible clock speed at low temperatures, the laptop gets really noisy, around 60 decibels. Thankfully, on idle and during basic tasks, the fan noise is not an issue at all. The 2018 model has no turbo button, but you can manually overclock the GPU and set the fan speed to maximum in Predator Sense application. On idle it's slightly louder than new Predator, but under heavy load it's quieter, around 55 decibels. If it comes to the temperatures, it's impressive that despite overclocking the graphics and increasing the power limits of such powerful CPU, the Predator is able to maintain the average temperature of 83 degrees Celsius on the processor and 71 degrees on the GPU. Worth mentioning is that it comes undervolted by -0.125 volts from the factory, and that's probably a big part of such good results. In older Predator you have to care about undervolting yourself, and it's highly recommended if you want to keep the temperatures below 90 degrees Celsius. In the same test, the average temperature of the CPU was 88 degrees Celsius and the temperature of the GPU was 77 degrees. Now if you would like to upgrade the 2018 Predator you have easy access to your RAM and 2.5 inch hard drive. The M.2 SATA SSD is not available through these windows and to swap it out you have to take off the bottom. In 2019 model you have to unscrew whole the bottom lid to get access to your RAM, 2.5 inch hard drive and 2 M.2 PCIe slots that allow you to install a much faster SSD than in older Predator. I made a step-by-step detailed guide where I'm showing you how to disassemble and upgrade each laptop, so if you're planning to add more RAM, swap out your hard drive or SSD, you can check it out. As for the battery life, I managed to use the old model for 4 hours and 10 minutes when browsing the web and doing light productivity work. When gaming, battery died after 1 hour. The new model has been significantly improved if it comes to battery life. It runs 6 hours when light work and 1.5 hours when gaming. Alright, it seems to be everything that you need to know to wisely choose one of these laptops. But before we finish, let me share my closing thoughts. So if it comes to the old model, I think that despite high temperatures, it's still a very good choice if you can't really save up 200 $100 more for the new generation. It's very hard to find a laptop with GTX 1060, i7-8750H processor, 16GB of RAM and 144Hz display for only $1000, and if you are lucky you can grab it for $900 on sale. Since the new model comes with more powerful hardware now, the 2018 Predator became a budget option which still offers much more than other brands' gaming laptops in this price point. It has premium metal build, excellent display, and it performs fast enough to play current AAA titles on high settings at smooth 60 frames per second. On the other hand, we have the new generation, which is basically much better in every aspect. It costs only $1200, but you can get it for only $1000 when it's on sale. Beside the price, the biggest advantage of the 2019 Predator is the performance. The laptop constantly works on highest possible clock speeds, and despite increasing the CPU power limit, it doesn't usually exceed 85 degrees Celsius. It's also smaller, lighter, and it has much longer battery life than previous generation, which makes it more suitable device for those who travel a lot. And finally, the display of 2019 Predator will meet the expectations of gamers, but also the content creators. I'm really surprised by the quality and such fast performance in a laptop this small. I'm actually considering switching to the 2019 Helios 300 over all the laptops that I've tested. And what is your choice? If you know which laptop you're gonna buy now, let us know in the comments. If you're new to the channel, it would be awesome if you consider subscribing Tech Finds. On my channel you can find detailed laptop reviews, laptop comparisons, gaming benchmarks and more. Now thanks for your time and see you in the next video.